In this clip, we'll talk about creating the caustics effect in water. In real life, the sun or any other light source emits an unlimited number of photons. When these photons are reflected or refracted by a curved surface, like wavy water in this example, not only shadows but curved regions of bright light are cast. These shadows and curved regions of bright light can be seen on the bottom and on the walls of the pool. To have a cleaner picture of what caustics look like, let's dive into the water with the camera and take a look. The first image shows the underwater world without caustics being rendered, and the second one with caustics on. As you can see, caustics is more obvious when observed underwater than from above. Therefore, it matters a lot from what angle the water is seen by the camera. As an example, here's an aerial view, and another one when the camera is close to the ground. It's important to prepare a proper water surface in order to have caustics. A flat water surface will not cast any noticeable caustics. For a reference, let's examine the properties of the water surface material we are using in this scene. This particular water material is different from the ones you'll find in ArchiCAD's built-in library because it's specially prepared to be used with the caustics effect. The color and diffuse channels are both off. The transparency channel uses the following values shown here. Here's the reflection channel, where we employ a Fresnel shader. And now the specular channel. Feel free to copy the values shown to your own project and experiment finding the right settings for your own needs. In addition, we use a normal direction shader within the specular channel. The bump channel is crucial as it's responsible for creating the waviness of the water. Please note, it creates no real geometrical waviness. If we take a closer look, we can see that indeed the water remains flat. The bump channel only creates a visual illusion of a wavy surface. Still, during the rendering calculation, because of the settings in the bump channel, the water is interpreted as a wavy surface, and as a result, caustics will be generated. Besides proper surface material for water, another key factor is lighting. In this scene, we have a few spotlights around the edges that are responsible for lighting the pool at night. These are not enough for caustics to be generated in the whole pool. We need a light source that covers the complete surface of the water. At the moment, only the spotlight object is suitable for this purpose. One spotlight is not enough for a pool of this size. We need 12. You might think, why not use only one spotlight placed high above the pool with an outer angle set to 180 degrees? The truth is that the effect of caustics would be too weak. There's a tight connection between the shape of waves and the resulting caustics effect, the distance between the water surface and the lamp object, and the number of photons beamed from the lamp towards the water. If these parameters are not balanced, the result may be disappointing. If the spotlight is too high, the caustics will be too weak or even invisible. If it's too close, the spotlight will not illuminate enough of the surface, and you will have to place even more lamps, which will result in longer render times. The spotlight has to be above the water. It can't be placed below the water surface. The number of photons being emitted is also crucial. In this example, each lamp emits 1.5 million photons towards the water. The default value here is 10,000, but usually it's not enough. Don't forget to change this value to a higher number. As we use these spotlights for creating the caustics effect exclusively and not for lighting the scene, it's important to turn on the ignore diffuse channel and the ignore specular channel options. Also, make sure to turn off the use global illumination switch. Finally, the intensity is at 50%. In the Render Settings dialog, the Caustic option, under Effects, must be turned on. Also, make sure to turn on the Surface Caustic switch. The Strength parameter can be used to amplify the final result. Please note, calculating caustics is yet another time-consuming process, and it will dramatically increase the render time. Although CineRender is capable of using all cores in the CPU, some calculations are limited to one core only. We have 12 spotlights that create the caustics effect, and each lamp is calculated one by one using one core only. Only after this initial preparation are all cores of the CPU engaged by CineRender.